Welcome to worship. Today, we'll be continuing our message series, Highs and Lows, a series of epiphanies. And, you know, I'm just so excited to be able to be back here for y'all doing these videos. Anyways, welcome to Youth Sunday. And
get out. This is Youth Sunday. Youth only.
Offering baskets are located at the entrance of the sanctuary. Please feel free to drop off your offerings in the basket. We will also have our mug money missionary in the back. Our missionaries this quarter is the first option care. For more information on this awesome missionary, please contact the Megan Children Church for those up to second grade. When promoted, please text quickly and quietly with your children church leader. We are in need of kids' life group, children, churches, and nursery. Volunteers, please see Kayla if you are able to volunteer in one of these missionary areas.
Our ushers are in the back. Please see one of our ushers if you need assistance in the worship. We have several events happening at the church. Today, a lot is happening. We have Super Bowl Sunday. Start bringing in your non-perishable food items today. Let's see if we can fill the altar. It is also Youth Sunday, if you haven't noticed. You know, I don't really want to do this anymore. John, come back.
Really? I can come back? Really?
Anyways, for a full list of announcements, please check out our website at www.thechurchgrady.org. Now, let's prepare our hearts for worship.
This is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles.
Welcome to the building of 1400. I'm looking for the church.
We are here.
You are here and you're looking beautiful today. And we're thankful for those of you joining us today online and in person, as well as those that will watch later. Did things look a little different today?
Yeah.
Of course they do. Welcome to Youth Sunday. The youth are thankful for the opportunity to serve in many different positions today. Let us know if there's anything we can do to better serve you. In the spirit of things looking a little different today, and because it is almost Valentine's Day, we would like to share some love to our worship band, members this morning by presenting them with small gifts of appreciation from your church family. We love and appreciate all you do for us each week. So where were we? Oh yeah. Today we continue the message series, Highs and Lows. You will hear from some of our recent Chrysalis attendees as they share about their Chrysalis experience. We hope you will all stay for lunch during our chili cook-off. We have two more Sundays in this message series, so invite someone to join you because we aren't done yet. Christian sympathy to Mr. and Ms. Jacob Odom in the death of Kayla's grandmother. Many prayer concerns have been shared through the Facebook group. I'm sure many of you have some unspoken concerns, as I do. He hears those as well. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for loving us the way that you do. We are so thankful for this day that you have given us. Thank you for allowing the youth to serve you, Lord. We are so grateful for all that you have done. Thank you for creating each one of us in your image. I pray for our youth as we serve you this morning, Lord. Thank you for allowing us to be your hands and feet of Jesus. I ask that we continue to be a light for you today and every day moving forward. I pray that each day we wake up ready to be your willing disciples. Lord, thank you for the community gathered around us. I ask that every day we wake up that we will seek to encourage one another to build up your kingdom. I ask for your Holy Spirit to meet us wherever we are at this very moment. I ask that you be with our youth speakers this morning, Lord, that you will bless them and the rest of us by the stories that they share this morning. We ask these in the blessed holy name. Amen.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. And holy, there's no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me. Worthy of every song. Worthy of it. on, church, and show me who you are.
Walk up and prepare themselves. Let's sing that chorus one more time. Sing Beautiful Name.
What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to grace.
As they're stepping down, will you thank the band for what they do? I now know how hard it is to be up there. It's very nerve-wracking.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
How's everybody doing this morning? My name is Aubrey Walden, South Georgia Chrysalis Flight 49, Table of Goat. Girls of Almighty Trust.
Matt. My name is Lily Walton, South Georgia Chrysalis Flight 49, Table of the Pretty Papillons.
Thanks for joining us this morning, either in person or on Facebook Live. We are currently in a message series. We're discussing God being greater than our highs and lows in our life. In a Christian calendar, we are also currently in the season of Epiphany. During this time, we are paying special attention to the epiphanies we experience within our highs and lows. 1 month ago, I got to experience God firsthand at Chrysalis. If you don't know what Chrysalis is, it's a 72-hour walk with God for teenagers. There's a girls' walk and there's a boys' walk. This is a spiritual experience that is very similar to what it takes a caterpillar to become a butterfly. At the beginning of this experience, though, I was still a larva. Within the last few years, I've been in a dark place mentally and spiritually. I grew up in church. I knew who God and Jesus were, but I had no relationship with Christ at all. 5 years ago, I was diagnosed with end-stage kidney failure. I was on dialysis for a year, and then shortly after, I received my kidney transplant. It was one of the most scariest and painful things I've ever had to go through. Then in May of 2020, my mother lost her battle to heart disease. I hated and blamed God. I grew up hearing that God was kind and would never let me down. But how could this be true if all I felt was betrayal and hurt? And it wasn't until my flight I learned how to forgive Christ, and I realized that God had a plan for me. Whoever conceals their sins does not prosper, but one who confesses them and renounces them will find mercy. Proverbs 28:13. This is the word of God from the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
I never thought that a 3-day camp would change so much in my life as a Christian.
Going into this Chrysalis experience, I was not in a good place with God either. You could say that I was in a low. I stopped really paying attention in church and was just going through the motions. I was there every Sunday because I was told I had to go. But during the message and worship, I would just zone out. So when it started to get closer in the weekend, in my mind, I was just going to fly under the radar and go through the motions like I normally do. But little did I know that I would do the exact opposite.
Chrysalis wasn't at all what I was expecting. I honestly thought it was going to be boring and we were going to be listening to somebody read the Bible the whole weekend. The closer it got to the weekend, the more I was considering not going at all. But I was totally wrong. I experienced Christ firsthand. If you are considering going on a Chrysalis flight, please do it. You will not regret it. Even if you believe that you checked off all the boxes of being a devoted and dedicated Christian, this experience will change your mind, influence you, and encourage you to become more intentional with your growth with Christ.
As I was about to leave for camp, I was nervous and did not want to go. I was most worried about whether or not I was going to make friends because I did not know if I could go the whole weekend without having any friends. When I arrived at camp, I immediately saw Kayla and my nerves relaxed a whole lot because I knew that if I didn't make friends, at least I would have Kayla.
Well, keep in mind, me and Anna were there at the same time, but thank God for Kayla.
Surprise, surprise, I did make friends. As I said before, I did not expect this experience to go the way it did. But by the end of it, I felt like I had been thrown upside down, sideways, and back again. I had literally been slapped in the face with the love of Jesus. I cried and cried all weekend long. I don't think I've ever cried that much in my entire life. Tears of joy, by the way. On Sunday, when I saw my family and friends, I literally could not stop talking. I was so overfilled with joy on the way home, I don't think I took a single breath.
My Christmas flight truly was a life-changing experience that showed me the true meaning of agape love and the importance of having a Christian community to fall onto. Having a Christian community is a big deal. It's important as we walk and grow in our faith. When we are close in relationships with other Christians, we have people to pray for us, support us, encourage us, and serve alongside us.
When I think about what this experience meant to me and what I would do with it, tons of thoughts rush into my head as I relive my experience. To sum it up, I realized God had shown me that weekend that I need to stop being a people pleaser and relying on others' opinions, and that the only validation I need is from Him.
For me, since I've gone through Chrysalis, I want to share my newfound love for Christ with others, continue my growth with Christ, stay involved with church and youth, and share how accepting God has changed my life as a Christian. I strongly encourage each and every one of you to stay plugged in, connected with other Christians, go on a flight, grow as a Christian, and be accountable, and try to live in a Christ-like manner. This is the way. Walk in it. Isaiah 30:21. Chrysalis was truly a high point for me in my spiritual journey. I needed that weekend to show me how to start building my relationship with Christ, to learn how to forgive and accept God's love for me. Even though I refused to acknowledge His goodness and authority, Christ forgave me. He was always there for me through the highs and lows. I was so caught up in the worldly and material things, I failed to realize it. Now I praise God every day for helping me get through the lowest points in my life, and apologizes for not being able to realize how much He loves me and does for me every single day.
I remember one night I was at the altar praying. God had given me an epiphany moment. I was praying about how I wanted God to use me to serve His name and how I wanted to be a light for Him. I also prayed to have no shame in my faith. As I was saying amen and getting up, I realized I was the only one left at the altar. I felt like God was telling me right then and there to be shameless. The next Sunday, I went to the altar, and I was praying for God to guide me and help me as I went back to school. When I said amen, I got up and realized I was the only one left. God showed me that even if I was the last one standing, I needed to be grounded in my faith.
While I was on my flight, I also had an epiphany moment. Wow, I get it. I finally understand. I now realize that God was never trying to punish me or pick on me, but allowing us to experience failure, pain, and struggle, we will grow closer and stronger in our faith and start moving away from sin. God allows for struggle to build our inner strength and faith. God takes care of us in the here and the now. He will enter into your mind and into your life if you will let Him. He will give you the knowledge and power to live your life successfully. In order to continue seeing God work in your life, go to church, study the Bible, pray actively, and look for what God is saying to you, how He wants you to turn your life around, and how He promises to guide you through the whole way. Without Chrysalis, I would still be in that dark place. I would have no relationship with Christ. I wouldn't be reading my Bible. I wouldn't be praying. I wouldn't be able to sit here right now and tell you just how grateful I am to be a child of God. Please consider Chrysalis. It's truly a life-changing experience There's also an adult version of this called Walk of Emmaus. I would love to sponsor anyone who would like to go. We are all unworthy children of a worthy King. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. 2 Corinthians 5:17. We are now beautiful. We are now beautiful butterflies. De coloris. Now let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for loving us the way that you do. Some of us have lost our way. Father, I ask that you lead us closer to you. Guide us to grow in our faith. Endure us with wisdom, patience, and courage, so that we may strengthen the weak and rise up the ones who have fallen. Lead us to be inspired by your love, God. We pray that you fill our hearts and our minds and our souls. We gathered here today to give thanks for helping us through our highs and lows, and we praise your greatness. Please give strength to those who are not yet butterflies. Help guide them to go on a walk or a flight, then strengthen their journey with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now let's go. Do we worship? We're going to enjoy some chili.
At this time, we are going to open up the altar. If you would like to come up and pray, we will leave you alone. And if you would like someone to pray with you, just raise a hand and someone will come. If you have never accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, Aubrey and I would love to have a conversation with you about that. If you are a member of another church, we believe in the priesthood of all believers. So we do not have members here, we have partners in ministry. And if you are looking for a church home, we would say,
welcome home.
Don't be worried about being the last one standing. It is your time. The altar of the Lord is now open.
Introduced in the Chrysalis community as South Georgia Chrysalis Flight 49 Table of the Fireflies. So, as y'all may have heard earlier, the youth is having a chicken right after the service. So, if y'all are willing to stay for 30 minutes to an hour, depending on how long we socialize, there's plenty of chili in the back. It's to help raise money for the youth group, and so the youth is hosting today, as you can tell. So I just wanted to send y'all off with a prayer and say that y'all all look beautiful this morning. So if y'all will bow your heads with me. Lord, Heavenly Father, Lord, I just ask that you help guide these beautiful people throughout their lives, Lord. And as we go into this chili cook-off today, I just ask that you bless the food and you bless the people that we decide to cherish and spend our time with today, Lord. I just thank you for all your many blessings and all the many days that you have bestowed upon us and that you will continue to bestow upon us with these amazing people. And I ask that you wish everybody luck today in the chili cook-off and that you just make it a great celebration of you and of the amazing people that decide to celebrate you, Lord. Amen.